the Swan Station. Today, we're going to be showing you how to put a polymer clay on the outside of a central oil sample bottle so that you can have decorated little sample bottles around your house or, you know, at your office, or you could use one as like a perfume bottle if you have a particular blend of oils you like to wear. So these are really fun and they're really good as gifts as well. And I love polymer clay, so this is always a very exciting project and they turn out really cool. Mm-hmm.
You can make really cool designs and shapes and anything you want really on it.
Mm-hmm. And you don't even have to know anything about polymer clay. You can do base colors, just bold colors, and then you could paint on them. There's no unlimited possibilities. So,
let's get to it.
So polymer clay is really nice. It's very versatile. It mixes really well with other colors. So I have 6 bottles here. I'm gonna start with this one. I'm gonna do a base color here. So I have a rolling pin, but you can use an oil bottle. You could use a rolling pin for cooking. I have a glass one. You can use just about anything. Polymer clay is really easy. You can pick it up at Michael's. You can pick it up just about anywhere that they sell craft supplies. I like to also use this little, like a little blade. If you're a child, please ask your parents' permission before using sharp blades or X-Acto knives or craft knives like this. You can use regular knives. You could use just about anything to cut it. I just like the thin slices that I can get with this. So I'm just gonna do a basic of this color. I'm just gonna knead it for a second. And as it heats up, it's more pliable and easier to work with. I like to do polymer clay really thin on bottles like this. However, you can do it really, really thick and heavy. If you do that, it takes longer to bake. The thinner the layer, the faster it is to bake. However, thinner, you do have to be careful that there's not any cracks in it. So I'm just gonna roll this fairly thin. I'm gonna take the polymer clay, and I've got a couple speckles of other colors in here, but that's gonna be all right. And it can be pretty thin for this one. Try to get the widest spot I can here. Just peel that away. I'm gonna take the bottle. I like to go just a little bit under the lip, but you can go all the way over if you'd like. Then I'm gonna cut the extra right here. I'm just gonna rub it in right here, where it overlaps, cut off the extra here. And you can also use a blade or anything you have that's flat and use it to help depress out the line from where you had to mash them together. All right, now you can see the bottle on the bottom. I'm gonna press it like this, press it down so it gets a flat bottom. And then I'm gonna add a little more material because it's not quite enough. Press it so I know it's gonna sit flat, and it looks good down there, looks good up here, and that is a plain colored oil bottle. And a lot of people like to make rolls with polymer clay as well, where you make a lot of thin little lines and then you roll them together in a ball to make flower patterns and all kinds of cool stuff. And those take a long time, so I'll do one with some rolls I already have, and you can look up tutorials on how to do those if you want to use that kind of a pattern. There's a lot of different ways to blend. You can just put a bunch of pieces together randomly, a pile of clay, and just play with it. I like to do this, and then just break it in half and roll. So see, I broke it in half and then I rolled it, and so it's starting to mix, and then I just keep doing that until I get a good pattern. Now I have a really cool mix here that I'm gonna roll out for my next oil bottle, and there is my second bottle. And I'm gonna do one with a pattern I've been working on that I already did. It's called a log or a tube, and it's where I made a bunch of tiny of those rolls. And I made a pattern with them. So because this one already had such a complex pattern from what I'd made earlier, this one actually looks pretty cool altogether. And then this one, the other pattern, is pretty cute too. It's very zebra. So these are mine. Yay! And I will bake these, and then they will be good for oils to go into. So that is how you make polymer clay covered oil bottles. And these are really great for labeling certain blends of oils you made or giving away as gifts. You could mix up a special blend, give it away as a gift in a cute little bottle, or you could give it to your kids. You know, maybe you have a star and moon one for the one that they're supposed to use around bedtime, or maybe a sun for one that you want them to smell in the morning, right? So there's a lot of cool applications to these. They're super easy to make, they're super fun. You can even have kids, adults, everyone can make one. So one of my favorite things to do with the fancier designed ones, the ones with the more intricate design, is to use them as kind of like a perfume bottle. So I will take my favorite blend of oils, or I'll blend, mix some of my favorite oils together, and I'll carry that with me. And it's got this special little bottle, so I know that it's not just a normal sample bottle, and I always know what's in it. And it's just a fun way to spruce up your essential oil collection.
Remember to comment down below which one is your favorite oil bottle. Remember to like and subscribe and click the bell to get notified whenever we upload.
Be sure to check out our social media down in the description box below. We love to interact with you guys, and sometimes we post special surprises or hints to videos before they actually come out. And we'll see you next time at the Swan Station.
Bye!